traditional, I mean more formal clothes, for example, in the men and women. So in the case of food, there was more health, because before there wasn't much more fast food or things like that.
Exactly.
And before, also the exercise was more because the family was more united.
Okay, yes, people, well, families were bigger also, right? They used to have more kids and they had a lot of work at home because of having a big family. Yes, the clothes have changed. You're right, Daniel. People used to dress a little bit more formal, as you said. Well, men used to wear suits, ties, and they were always elegant. Not as today. Today we are more like casual, we can say, or sporty, but not so formal. Very good. Can you help me, please, also telling me what has changed? Caro, Carolina Burga, what has changed? What changes can we see?
The clothes.
Mm-hmm. What's the difference with the clothes?
It's more reserved.
Yes, they are more reserved. Mm-hmm. What happened with the food? Can you tell me what's the difference with the food, Emory? What happened before? What do people used to eat?
The people eat in the family.
Yes, they used to eat together, mm-hmm, in family.
And the family eat more health.
Mm-hmm. They used to have a healthy diet, right? Solían tener también una dieta un poco más saludable, ¿no? Okay. What do you think about the exercise, Alexander? Alexander Quiroz, what do you think with the exercise?
Sorry, teacher, will you repeat the question?
Sure. How do you think exercise has changed? For example, do you think that in these years, people used to exercise more, maybe?
I think that the people in this case and who and didn't run for much time. Now the people usually do exercise every weekend in the parks and gyms. Yeah, it's a teacher.
Thank you. Maybe people used to exercise less before or not go running outside as much as we do today. Okay, so the first thing we have here is this phrase, used to. We're going to see how to use this phrase, okay? This is a phrase in past, as you can see. The verb is in past because it's ending in ed. But this phrase has something peculiar. Okay, it's not you. The meaning is not. Si el significado de este used to no sería como usé, sí, como el pasado literal del verbo, sino que más bien el used to tiene el significado de solía. Es decir, que nos referimos a acciones o sucesos o hechos que hacíamos en el pasado y que ahora ya no los hacemos. O por el contrario, cosas que no hacíamos antes y que ahora sí las realizamos. ¿Sí? Es decir que es lo opuesto, ¿no? Si algo yo no lo hacía, ahora ya se entiende, si yo utilizo este used to, se entiende que ahora yo ya lo estoy haciendo. ¿Sí? Esa es la, el uso de este used to. So, como les decía, nos va a servir mucho para hablar de hábitos o actividades que realizábamos en el pasado, ¿sí? Pero que en el momento actual ya no ocurren, ¿sí? For example, here we have some phrases. We have this one. Can you help me reading this one, please? Kathy Montaño, help me read in this phrase.
I used to play soccer.
Mm-hmm. I used to play soccer. Sí, solía jugar fútbol. Este solía jugar fútbol quiere decir que, o nos da a entender que en la actualidad ya no juega fútbol, ¿no? I used to play football. Yo solía jugar fútbol. Si antes yo realizaba esta actividad, ahora se entiende que ya no lo estoy haciendo más, ¿sí? Pero también podemos utilizar estas oraciones de forma negativa, ¿sí? Es decir, referirnos a cosas que antes no hacíamos, ¿sí? Si antes no lo hacíamos, significa que ahora sí. Vamos a ver, ayúdame leyendo, please, a Sebastián.
Okay, teacher, we didn't used to watch TV when we were younger.
Mm-hmm. We didn't used to watch TV when we were younger. Si no solíamos ver mucha televisión cuando éramos más jóvenes. Significa que ahora sí vemos más televisión, ¿no es cierto? That's the case. Look at this. When you were using used to in past, it would be considered as an affirmative way. ¿Sí? Hay que mantener el concepto, la idea de que esta palabrita used to está en pasado. ¿Sí? En este caso, si vemos que está con la D al final, es porque es una oración en pasado de forma afirmativa. Pero ¿qué pasa si queremos hacerle negativa? Como decíamos que es una oración, una frase, no un verbo en pasado, nos vamos a valer del auxiliar. In this case, didn't. ¿Sí? Por eso en esta oración nosotros ocupamos el didn't para formar o para crear más bien esa oración de forma negativa. ¿Sí? No se olviden, estamos básicamente recordando el tiempo pasado en este caso. Sí, utilizamos el didn't. ¿Y qué pasa con el verbo use? Si está en pasado. Y ya estoy utilizando el auxiliar.
¿Se mantiene en la forma normal?
Ajá, exacto. Se mantiene en la forma original. Es decir, que no vamos a ocupar la D al final. Únicamente ya ocupamos el auxiliar didn't. No, por ejemplo, we didn't use to watch TV when we were younger. No escribimos la D porque ya el pasado o nos está indicando el pasado, el auxiliar didn't en este caso. También podemos preguntar, ¿sí? También podemos preguntar y para preguntar también nos vamos a valer del auxiliar. In this case, we're going to use just did. Solo vamos a utilizar el auxiliar did, ¿no? Para preguntar. Did he use to drink alcohol? ¿No? ¿Solía él tomar alcohol? We would be asking or making a question. Y ahí estaríamos creando una pregunta. Did he used to drink alcohol? So I know just explaining it's not going to work. I know that you need to make some exercises. It's going to be easier for us if we make some exercises so we can have a clear idea of this or how to use this. Ya vamos a hacer un par de ejercicios para que quede mucho más claro el uso de esta frasecita used to. Okay, let me see. Here we have another example, so I'm going to read. I'm going to ask you, Ma, to help me reading this one. Help me, please, in this case, Edith, can you help me reading this one, please? Just the example.
I use it be virgin in a wine mash store.
Exactly. I used to be very thin. Look at this. In 2013, I used to be very thin. Today, I'm much stronger. That's the meaning. ¿Sí? Si nosotros utilizamos el I used to be, ¿sí? Yo solía ser muy flaquito en el pasado, ¿no? Eso significa que ahora es todo lo opuesto, todo lo contrario. Now I'm much stronger, dice. Ahora soy mucho más fuerte. ¿Cómo sería o cómo harían ustedes esta misma oración? I used to be very thin, de forma negativa. Si ustedes quieren decir, yo no solía ser muy flaquito. How would it be? Can you help me with that, please? Jody, ¿cómo nos quedaría? Yo no solía ser flaquito. How would it be?
I didn't use.
I don't use to be very thin.
Okay. Acuérdense que estamos hablando del pasado.
I didn't use to be very thin.
Okay, I didn't use to be very thin. Eso significa que antes era gordito y ahora sí es flaquito. Okay, so I'm going to share with you the book. So you can see some exercises. Give me a second. And we make some exercises in groups so you can have a better understanding of these used to phrase. How would it be?
She's used to a manager. Before she stopped working.
Okay. Este verbo de aquí, ¿qué verbo es? Be. Be, right? El verbo to be. Es el mismo. Acuérdense que en este caso, estos verbos que están subrayados, tendríamos que cambiarlas a forma presente. ¿No? Entonces, ¿cómo nos quedaría? She
used to is a manager before she stopped working.
Used to, okay, thank you. Aquí nuestro compañero nos dice she used to is, right? El verbo to be para ella en presente sería. Y eso sería lo más lógico. Pero La regla lo que nos está diciendo es que en realidad el verbo sería, look at this. Mantendríamos la forma en infinitivo. She used to be, vamos a ocupar, she used to be. Ella solía ser. No vamos a ocupar específicamente ya el verbo to be conjugado, sino el verbo to be de forma general. ¿Sí? Es bueno tener aquí un ejemplo con este was para que ustedes se den cuenta. Si ustedes quieren referirse a ser, ¿sí? Yo solía ser, vamos a ocupar el to be completo. She used to be a manager before she stopped working. Okay, she used to be. We have another question right here. Tenemos otra pregunta. ¿Cómo transformamos con el used to esta pregunta? Did your parents read you stories when you were young? Sí, queremos decir, ¿solían tus padres leerte una historia cuando eras más joven, cuando eras más pequeño? How do you think this question would be? ¿Cómo nos quedaría esta pregunta?
Did your parents used to read your stories when you were young?
Very good. Did your parents used to? The end of verb, used to read you stories when you were young. Very good. Les pongo por acá porque ya no me alcanza por ahí. Let's continue with the next, number 6. I didn't like vegetables when I was a child. How would it be? No solían gustarme. ¿Cómo diríamos?
I didn't used to like vegetables when I was a child.
Exactly, Elvis. Very good. I didn't used to like. I didn't used to like vegetables when I was a child. Excellent. Let's move to the next question. Now we have a question. Were you a good student at the school? ¿Eras un buen estudiante en la escuela? ¿Cómo diríamos solía ser un buen estudiante? Acuérdense de lo que pasó en la número 4. How do we make a question right here?
Did you use it to be you a good student at school?
Very good, Adrian. Did you used to be a good student at the school? ¿Podría ser un buen estudiante en la escuela? Did you used to be? Very good. And let's do the last one. Tenemos ya la última. Once again with the verb to be. Una vez más con el verbo to be. We weren't as fit as we are today. No éramos tan saludables como lo somos ahora. ¿Cómo diríamos? No solíamos ser saludables. How would it be? Let me see. Can you help me with that?
Yo, teacher, puede ser. Okay. Sí. Sería, we didn't used to be as fit as we are today.
Very good. We didn't used to be. Excellent. As fit as we are today. Sí, no solíamos ser tan, no solíamos estar tan en forma como estamos ahora, ¿no? Very good. So now we have the last exercise. Up to now, you have been very good with the exercise. You got the idea and you are very good with these forms. Let's find out the next exercise. In this exercise, we will have to look at the picture. We have two pictures, right? The past and today. 10 years ago and today. Right here. What are we going to do? We are going to see all the changes these people have gone through these 10 years. So look at the pictures of Mary and Jeff 10 years ago and today. Write sentences about how they have changed. Use used to or didn't used to and the words in the brackets, okay? So you're going to see the changes these two people have gone through, and you're going to make sentences using used to or didn't used to and the phrases or the words you have on the brackets. For example, in this case, have a long hair. In the next sentence, be thinner, wear suits, look after the garden, and so on. So can you help me doing these sentences, please? Vamos haciendo estas oraciones. For example, if it's a little bit easier, I think that maybe you can work better as a team. Let me see. Vamos a ver, ¿cómo nos quedarían entonces estas? Let me see, someone who hasn't participated yet. Help me reading, please, Marjorie. Food and drink.
Food and drink. People didn't choose to worry about how many calories they ate. The government advised people to eat meat, cheese, butter, cereal, and bread every day. They also recommended 2 glasses of milk a day. Today, the advice has changed. They say we should eat more vegetables and less meat, cheese, and butter. But we don't listen. Not many of you eat a healthy diet. 60% of Jews are now overweight. In the UK, the everyday woman will spend 31 years of her life on a diet. For a man, it's 28 years.
Exactly. Thank you. So here we have some of the things that have changed with this topic of food and drink. Do you agree that people didn't used to worry about the calories before? What do you think? Do you agree with this phrase right here? La gente no solía preocuparse de las calorías que comía. What do you think? Is it true or false? What do you think?
False, teacher.
Why? Why do you think it's false?
Because in the graphic of the text say the people today ¿cómo se decía? Pesado. Era
heavy.
Ajá, is more heaviest because eating more.
Okay, yes, people eat more, but also there has been like a change. I don't know if you have heard to your grandmothers worrying about the calories. Tal vez les han escuchado a las abuelitas decir, uy, es que este caldito de pollo tiene 100 calorías. Have you heard that? ¿Les han oído hablar así? I haven't personally, I haven't heard my grandmother said that. But I have heard some teenagers saying that. Sí, lo que sí he escuchado es a muchos adolescentes, sobre todo chicas, preocuparse de eso. Dicen, uy, no puedo comer, por ejemplo, el mote con chicharrón, porque el chicharrón tiene muchas calorías, ¿no? So people is very worried nowadays about the calories they eat. Sí, la gente se preocupa ahora mucho de qué tiene el producto. If you are aware, when you go to the supermarket or maybe to the store to buy something, on the back of the product you have, this is high in sugar, this is less in oil, and things like that. Sí, ahora como la gente se preocupa tanto por las calorías, sí, incluso el gobierno sacó lo de la semaforización en los productos, ¿no? Entonces ustedes ven en la parte de atrás del producto y ahí les dice, es alto en grasas, es alto en azúcar, es alto en sal, right? So people are very worried about the products they eat. Creo que ahora la gente es un poco más preocupada, ¿no? De lo que come. Look at this. Here on the reading we have, the government advised people to eat meat, cheese, butter, cereal, and bread every day. Sí, el gobierno aconsejaba a la gente lo que debía comer. Do you know... Or is there some words that you don't understand in this part of the reading? ¿Hay alguna palabra un poco desconocida o difícil en este párrafo? Any word that maybe you don't get the meaning? ¿Alguna palabra que no conozcamos el significado hasta esta parte de la lectura?
Overweight, teacher.
Okay, we have overweight right here. Is any other word maybe?
Average.
Average, okay. Over here, average woman. And we have also here, average weight. Muy bien. Any other? I think both are the new words right here. Sí, aquí tenemos un par de palabras nuevas. The word average means promedio. Sí, esta palabrita nos dice el peso promedio, ¿no? Average weight. Sí, el peso promedio en hombres y el peso promedio en mujeres. Let's see the meaning of this other one. Overweight. Overweight would be the opposite of being fit. Sí, sería lo opuesto de estar en forma, de tener un peso saludable. ¿Qué sería entonces overweight?
Sobrepeso.
Sobrepeso, exactly. Alguien que tiene sobrepeso. Someone who has had a lot, right? Alguien que ha comido demasiado, tiene sobrepeso. So not many of us eat a healthy diet. Aquí nos dice, no muchos de nosotros tenemos una dieta saludable. 60% of us are now overweight. El 60% de nosotros tiene sobrepeso. In the UK, the average woman En el Reino Unido, las mujeres promedio will spend 31 years of her life on a diet. Es decir, que las mujeres promedio en el Reino Unido van a pasar 31 años de su vida en dieta. See, for a man, it's just 28 years. Los hombres 28 años, un poco menos que las mujeres, pero dice que en general las mujeres están casi todo el tiempo a dieta, ¿no? Okay, so here we have the difference about food and drink. Let's find out what happened with the exercise. Vamos a ver qué pasaba con el ejercicio antes y ahora. Help me please read in this part. Araceli, can you help me read in this paragraph of exercise, please?
Exercise. Most women used to keep in shape. Naturally, be doing housework. The average housewife did 3 hours of housework every day. They didn't need to go to the gym to lose weight and get fit. Today, busy working lives made it harder to get enough exercise. Invention like washing machines, freezers, and cars have made our lives easier. So it's now much easier to put on weight.
Exactly. Thank you, Araceli. So most women used to keep in shape naturally by doing housework. Y la mayor parte de las mujeres se mantenían en forma, ¿no? They keep in shape. Se mantenían en forma naturalmente. ¿Haciendo qué? By doing what? According to the reading, what do women used to do? ¿Qué solían hacer las mujeres para mantenerse en forma?
Housework.
Housework, right, housework. Las tareas de la casa. Housework. That was their gym. Sí, ese era el gimnasio de las mujeres antes. Hacer las tareas de la casa. So, the average housewife did 3 hours of housework every day. Es decir, que hacían aproximadamente, ¿no?, unos 3 horas de estar arreglando la casa todos los días. They didn't need to go to the gym to lose weight or get fit. Es decir, que no necesitaban ir al gimnasio para perder peso o estar en forma, ¿no? Today, busy working lives make it harder to get enough exercise. Inventions like washing machines, freezers, and cars have made our lives easier. So it's much easier to put on weight. So what's the meaning of this one? You know washing machines, right? ¿Cuál es el significado de las washing machines?
Lavadora.
Las lavadoras, exacto, las lavadoras. What about freezers?
Where you... Refrigeradores.
Exacto, donde ponemos, ¿no es cierto? El helado, los vegetales, the freezers, right? Los congeladores o los refrigeradores. What about this phrase right here? La última. ¿Qué significaba, acuérdense, put on weight?
Ganar peso.
Aumentar peso. Exacto. Ganar peso o aumentar peso. Put on weight. Ganar o aumentar de peso. Exactly. So here we have some new words. Tenemos ahí, estábamos recordando también un par de frases, ¿no? What happened now with women? ¿Qué pasa ahora con las mujeres? Do they do a lot of housework? ¿Siguen haciendo mucho trabajo? Yes or no? I think that in some cases they do, right? Todavía continúan haciendo el trabajo de la casa. Most women, I think, la mayor parte de las mujeres. Let's continue reading this healthcare. Vamos al sistema de salud. Let's see the difference 70 years ago and now. Please help me reading this healthcare, Darwin. Darwin Medina, help me reading, please, this one.
Healthcare. People didn't used to live as long as we today. Hospital operations were much less common and people only used to go to the doctor when they were seriously ill. Today we live longer, but we have new health problems. In the 1950, mosquitoes drank milk and ate peanuts without any problems, but more people have allergies to various foods today. And the number of people who have diabetes is also increasing because more people are overweight.
Okay, thank you, Darwin. So people didn't used to live as long as we do today. La gente no solía vivir tanto como hoy. Mainly because they used to go to the doctor just when they were seriously ill. Sino principalmente porque iban al doctor solo cuando era ya enfermedades extremas. Cuando estaban muy, muy, muy enfermos, iban al doctor. Today we live longer, but we have new health problems. ¿Qué nuevos problemas de salud creen que tenemos hoy en día? Which new health problems do we have today? Which new health problems do we have? Elvis, ¿qué nuevos problemas de salud crees que tenemos ahora?
In my opinion, for example, diabetes.
Mm-hmm. Diabetes could be one. Very good. What about you, Edgar? Which new health problems do we have?
Overweight.
Overweight, exactly. That's a new problem. Tenemos dos, ¿no? Diabetes, el sobrepeso. What else? What other new health problem do we have?
Mi teacher, respiratory diseases from smoke.
Yes, we have respiratory problems because of the smoke. Yes, that's excellent. Because of the pollution could be also. Exactly. There's another very popular problem we have nowadays. Which one do you think?
Allergies.
COVID.
The COVID, yes, that's the new one. And allergies as well. Very good. Now people is allergic to everything, right? Ahora la gente es Alérgica a todo. Have you been or have you had any allergy? ¿Han tenido alergias? Some of you? Tell me.
Yes.
What have you been allergic to? ¿A qué han sido alérgicos?
To the lung.
Okay. What else? Now we have a lot of all allergies, right? To the food in some cases. En algunos casos es a la comida. En otros casos es en cambio a superficies, to some surfaces, or maybe to very strange things. Y también hay alergias muy extrañas. For example, some people are allergic to the light, to the extreme light. Or some others are allergic to the dust. Sí, algunos son alérgicos.